Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will discuss about remaining three parts of metal forming process, which is forming, extrusion, and drawing. In the previous chapter, we have seen that various aspects of rolling process, advantage of rolling process, disadvantage of rolling process, and various limitations of rolling process. In this lecture, remaining three types of metal from forming process, we will discuss about. The first one is forging process. Forging is perhaps the oldest metal working process and was known even during prehistoric days when metallic tools were made by heating and hammering. We have seen that in many villages are going to that one person with their agricultural tool. And the man, he is hitting that tool and hammering for more effective and more performing in the cultivation process. Forging is basically involves plastic deformation of material between two dies to achieve desired configuration. Depending upon complexity of the part, forging is carried out open die forging and closed die forging. Basically, this is the two types of forging process. One is open die forging and another is closed die forging. The open die forging and closed die forging is depend on how complex part we have to making form forging process. In open die forging, the metal is compressed by repeated blows by a mechanical hammer and shape is manipulated manually. In the other hand, in closed die forging, the desired configuration is obtained by squeezing the workpiece between two shaped and closed dies. In the next slide, we will discuss with diagram. Here, this is representing open die forging and this is representing closed die forging. We have seen that in open die forging, outer part is open. Apart from in the closed die forging, here is a totally pack of work material between dies. Here are the component which is using in forging process: ram, die, workpiece, die, and anvil. Similarly, here die, blank, flash, and die. Here are some theoretical part regarding open die forging and closed die forging. On squeezing, the die cavity gets completely filled and excess material comes out around the periphery of the die as flash, which is later trimmed. Here, this point is talking about the extra material removed from here, from these small cavities. And after the forging process, if any need a post machining process, then we trimmed extra part which is coming outside from the workpiece. Basically this situation created in closed die forging. Now the another way is press forming process. Press forging or draw forging are also two popular method in the closed die forging. Basically closed die forging divided into two groups, in further two groups. One is press forging and another is drop forging. In press forging, the metal is squeezed slowly by a hydraulic or mechanical press and component is produced in a single closing of die. Hence, the dimension accuracy is much better than the drop forging. Because in the press forging, metal is squeezed slowly by the means of hydraulic force or by the means of mechanical press or by the means of mechanical force, and the component is producing in a single closing of die. Here the requirement of post machining process is very less, so we can say that no trimming of workpiece is required in press forming. Both open and closed die forging process are carried out in hot as well as in cold stage. In forging, favorable grain orientation of metal is obtained. Here we have already seen that this represent open die forging and this is for closed die forging. Now the extrusion process. Extrusion is a relatively new process, and its commercial exploitation started early in the 19th century with the extrusion of lead pipe. Extrusion of steels became possible only after 1930, when extrusion chambers could be designed to withstand high temperature and pressure. In extrusion process, the material is compressed in a chamber and the deformed material is forced to flow through a die. The die opening corresponds to the cross section of the required product. It is basically a hot working process. However, for softer material, cold extrusion is performed. Here, from the diagram, you can better understand. This is the RAM. This is billets, mean viscous material, and this is the overall configuration of extrusion process. Now, here is placement of dies, and the outer workpiece, the outer diameter of workpiece is only depend on the die which is placed here. So we can say that what's our basic requirements, or what's we have to make, means how much diameter we have to needed, or how much width, length we have to needed. Thus, on the basis of these requirements, we place die at the outer side of the overall arrangement. And after pulling the force with the help of RAM, the material or the viscous material comes out from this die, designing with our required diameter. We have already discussed that it is very convenient with the using of hot material, and some softer material we can use in cold process also. Here this one is represent for direct extrusion, and this one is indirect extrusion. The main difference is between direct extrusion and indirect extrusion is the direction of flow of the material. We can see that in the direct extrusion, the RAM is applying in the direction of output of our desired shape. But in the indirect extrusion, we can see that the RAM is pulling in the opposite direction of obtaining diameter of workpiece, because the die and the position of die and the position of RAM is associated only one side in the indirect extrusion, and the other side is totally packed. This is the difference between direct extrusion and the indirect extrusion. Here one type of extrusion is hydrostatic extrusion. The difference between the overall arrangement is similar to the direct extrusion. Here this position is this position for RAM, and this is billets. Here some fillets are filled, which is helpful for the applying force on billets. Thus our process is much smooth respect of direct extrusion. So it is by the using of fluid in the this section, this is known as hydrostatic extrusion. Now the third one process is the drawing process. If we have to produce large quantities of wires, rods, tubes and other sections, then we are going with drawing process, which is basically a cold working process. In this process, the material is pulled through a die in order to reduce it to the desired shape and size. The material is pulling from the die. We have seen that in extrusion process, one RAM is using here or outer side of the arrangement, and we applying the total force on the RAM to extrude the material from die or from that cavity. But in the if you're talking about drawing process, then the pulling of that required material is necessary with help of any servo motors from this die, because die is always placed at the outer side of the overall arrangement. From drawing process, we can make long tubes, long wires. It is very convenient to produce long tube and long wires. In a typical wire drawing operation, once the end of the wire is reduced and passes through the opening of the die, gripped and pulled to reduce its diameter. Sometimes we are using this process for reducing diameter of wires. Here the overall arrangement you are seeing in this slide for the drawing process. Here the wire rolls. The diameter of this wire, if you compare the diameter of this wire with this wire, then this wire has less diameter compared to this wire, because this is the raw material for this process. This is the raw material for this extrusion drawing process. Here we are seeing that the wire roll is associated with one die, and the drop lag. Drop lag is pulling wire from the wire roll directly, and the one's diameter is decreased here. Means if this diameter has 6 mm diameter, then probably it reduced 2 mm diameter, and this is the wire with diameter of 4 mm. Then the way we use a sleeve wheel for going smoothly, and another die used for reducing again the diameter of that wire. Means here the raw material or the input of the diameter of this wire is 4 mm, and our require is overall 2 mm. Then we place another die with the diameter, with the opening diameter of 2 mm. Then the pulling this from this die, and the wire is bending in the finished draw block. We can say that we are reduced diameter from 6 mm to 2 mm. It is very convenient. We have already discussed that it is very convenient for wires or tubes. Here the another type of drawing is two type is drawing process. One is wire drawing process, which is suitable for production of wires, and the another is a tube drawing process, which is suitable for production of tubes. Tube drawing is also similar to the wire drawing, except the mandrel of appropriate diameter is required to form the internal hole. In the wire drawing process, we have seen that we using the die of only we require the diameter as per our required diameter of the wire. But in the tube drawing process, we use hollow die for producing internal hole in the pipes. Here are the two arrangement you are seeing in the slide. One is floating plug, and second one is moving mandrel. This process is also using for reducing the diameter and thickness of the tube. These are the various defects in the drawing process. First one is wrinkling in the flange. Second one is wrinkling in the on the wall. Third one is tearing. Fourth one is earring, and fifth one is surface scratches. These defects are common in the drawing process. Here are the some description of the defects which is occurring during the drawing process. Like wrinkling and buckling is avoided by applying a blank holder force through a blank holder. This is the appropriate method to reduce the various error in the drawing process. A blank holder force increases friction and hence the required punch load. The edges of the punch and dies are rounded for the easy and smooth flow of metal. Sufficient clearance is also provided so that sheet metal could be easily accommodated. Insufficient or large clearance may result into shearing and tearing of the sheet. These are the some methods which reduce the occurring error in the drawing process. Now here are the comparison of various metal forming process with advantage and with various advantages and limitations Like if you are talking about forging process, we are saying that there are two type of forging process. One is open die forging and another is closed die forging. These are the various advantages, like expensive tooling and equipment in the open die forging, simple to operate, wide range of workpiece sizes can be used, suitable for low production rate. These are the limitations of open die forging, can be used for simple shape only, fairly skilled operations are required, production rate is low, dimensional accuracy and surface finish achieved are poor or poorer. Finishing required for achieving final shape means we have to trim that object after open die forging. Then advantages of closed die forging is suitable for high production rate, can be used for production of complex shape, good dimension accuracy and reproductibility. Here are the limitations of closed die forging: high equipment and tooling cost, appropriate die set for production of each component, more than one step required for each forging. These are the some limitations of closed die forging. Here are the advantages of, and limitations of hot rolling. We have seen in the previous chapter. We have also seen in the previous chapter the various advantages and limitations of the cold rolling. These are the advantages of hot extrusion process: moderate cost of equipment and tooling, suitable for large reduction and complex section and long products can be produced. Limitations of hot extrusion process is only constant cross section can be produced. This is the main limitation of hot extrusion process. Components with thin walls are difficult to produce. A lubrication is always necessary in hot extrusion process. Dimensional accuracy and finish achieved are not good. Means the post machining process or trimming process is also necessary in the hot extrusion process. Here are the some advantages of impact extrusion, like high production rate, good finish and dimensional accuracy. Generally no finishing is required in the impact extrusion. It is suitable for production of thin section also. Here are some limitations of impact extrusion, like suitable for production of large component from softer material only, a deformation limited to a small reduction. Then the advantages and disadvantages or limitations of drawing process, like advantage of drawing process is low equipment and tooling cost, good surface finish dimensional accuracy, high production rate, long length of rounds, tubing. And here are limitations of drying process: deformation limited to a small reductions, production of constant cross section only, lubrication is always necessary in drawing process. Here the one type of drawing process, deep drawing, with advantages like high production rate, moderate equipment and tooling cost, good surface finish. And the limitations of deep drawing is limited to forming of thin sheets, forming of shallow or deep parts of simple shape only. And in this, post machining process is also required. Now these are the various defects commonly occurs in the forging process, like block forging, begin forging, wave buckles, lapse in finished forging, forging begin, die cavities are being filled, crack develop ribs, and crack propagate through ribs. These are the defects in the forging process. Here are the three defects which are commonly occurring in the extrusion process. One is surface cracking, second is piping, and third is internal cracking of the finished goods. Now on the basis of these three types of metal forming process, we are here for solve some multiple choice questions. Like, forming is a process, first one is forming is a process that changes the shape of the metal by changing its phase. Basically, question is asking this statement is true or false. We have seen that forming is a process that changes the shape of the metal by changing its shape, not its phase. Phase changing means liquid to solid, solid to gas. But in the metal forming process, we can see that from billets to sheets, and from balloons to wire, from balloons to rods, then this statement is false, because forming is a process that changes the shape of the metal by changing it shape, not phase. Here are the description of multiple choice questions. The another one question is, which of the following component is mainly manufactured by the performing metal forging? We have seen that the forging process in which we are using open die or closed die by applying the forces, mechanical force or hydraulic force, or we can say that hammering is necessary in the forging process. Then this question is asking about which type of there are various components of engine, and question is asking about which component is manufactured by metal forging process. Then the connecting rod is manufacturing from the forging process. Here are the description, like connecting rods is mainly manufactured by the forging operation, which is specifically known as hot forging process, while parts like piston, crankcase and engine blocks are manufactured by the casting process. The third one, multiple choice question is, the metal forging operation can only be performed by the manual means. No, it is not only performed by the manual means. It is a forming operation which usually perform hammering process to shape the metal part, because we were seeing that in the forging process, either we use open die or either we use closed die, followed by the mechanical force or the hydraulic force. Here another multiple choice question is, the question is, which of the following metal forming process performs squeezing out of material through a hole? We are seeing that in the extrusion process, the material coming after squeezing of the raw material or squeezing of the viscous material after applying the force from the ram. In the other hand, in the forging process, we use hammering or mechanical force or hydraulic force. In the rolling process, we use rolls. And in drawing process, apart from squeezing, we are using pulled out the wire and tubes in the drawing process. Then our option is extrusion process. We are going with extrusion process. Now the next multiple choice question is, metal forming process is a process in which the metal is deformed plastically to get into desired shape. This statement is true, because in the metal forming process, we change the shape from another shape to another shape, plastically changes we shape, because after the changing of its shape, this is not retaining its our original shape. We are knowing that the deformation occurs two types. One is plastically and one is elastically. In the elastically deformation, if we deform the shape and leave it, then it's come to its original shape. This is known as elastically deformed. And for the plastically deformed, if we change the shape of any material, then it can't be retain its original shape. Then this statement is true. Next question is, which of the following process is not the type of bulk forming process in the metal forming? Here we have seen that the rolling process, the forging process, the extrusion process, and the drying process is used for bulk forming of the substance, then the answer is bending. Bending is not suitable process for forming bulk material. Next question is, which of the following manufacturing process is mainly considered for producing the component of very high strength? If you're talking about a strength, then casting process, simple, we cast the component into die. Forging process, in forging process we use hammers, either we use in closed die forging, either we are using in open die forging. Extrusion process, we simply squeeze the material with the help of applying force on ram. And in the rolling process, there are three or four rolls which is transform materials into sheets. Here we can see that apart from these three processes, only forging process which is used the force, this force is either mechanical force or it would be a hydraulic force. Thus we can see that forging is a deformation process in which the material we are producing with very high strength. The another multiple choice question is, which of the following metal forming process is best suitable for making the wire? We have seen in the previous slide that wires and tubes are making form only drawing process. Here are the explanation of the above question. Now this is the overall form, three types of metal forming process like extrusion process, forging process and drawing process. We have seen that advantages, disadvantages, limitations and applications of these three processes. And on the basis of this class, we will solve 8 multiple choice question, which is generally asking in the interview section. In the next chapter, we will discuss about various types of modern manufacturing system. Thank you. Thank you. Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we will discuss about inventory and inventory management. We also discuss about the various types or the various methods of inventory management, like ABC analysis, FNS analysis. What are the needs of inventory and inventory management in any manufacturing unit or any production plant? Now we are going to cover this topic, inventory and inventory management, key inventory terms, cost of overall inventory, and the various inventory management techniques. Like, what is inventory? If we're talking about definition of inventory, then the meaning of inventory is a stock of goods. It can be a raw material stock, it can be finished good stock, or it can be moving inventory or moving goods in any production plant. Moving goods here represent the time duration between coming from raw material inventory to going to the finished good product, finished good inventory. The word inventory is understood difficult by the various author, but it commonly known as the storing of goods or the scoring of like parts, that is known as a spare inventory. But overall, the inventory is known as a storing or a stock of the goods. In a manufacturing concern, it may include raw material, work in progress, and the finished good stores. In retails, the amount of a stock present in retail outlet and ready to be distributed. Inventory is a list for goods and materials, or those goods and material themselves held available in a stock by a businesses. Here are the basic requirement of inventory management, like which point, which type of points would which type of points would determine the inventory management. Like, inventory management is a science about specify the shape and percentage of a stock's good. By applying inventory management, we can assume or we can predict how much raw material is needed and how much spare parts, raw material and machines we are going to need in near future for the production of according to our estimation. Inventory management also confirm the overall stock of finished good that the customer can't face the stock out problem. A proper planning of purchasing, storing and accounting should form a part of inventory management. It overall regulate the purchasing of raw material, the purchasing of machines, the purchasing of spare parts, and storing of all above, and accounting should form a part of inventory management. An efficient system of inventory management will determine like what to purchase, how much to purchase, from where to purchase, and where to store. Either we can store nearby our plant, or we can store from where we can purchase the goods. The purpose of inventory management is to keep the stock in such a way that neither there is overstocking or nor understocking. Because if we thinking about we purchase more and more raw material, then there is a overstocking and also stocking our money to store them, money to buy them, and money in the transportation cost of the that particular raw material. And if you're talking about understocking always reflect our production rate. If raw material is understocking, then our machine will be ideal. Then our machine may be ideal. Then our manpower may be ideal. This is the overall flow of the inventory from the supplier to the shipment of finished goods. Here, supplier represents the supply of the raw material to the company, and the shipment represents the delivery of the finished good to the end customer of any plant or to the end customer of the any product. Like, first one is delivery from supplier. If you're talking about raw material, then surely the raw material coming from any authorized supplier. When it come to our warehouse, then we check its quality checking. Then it goes to the warehouse. Warehouse here, it is known as raw material inventory. Then at the time of production, the raw material comes from warehouse and go for the material movement at the production floor for applying various machining processes or for applying various production processes on that raw material. After that, here material movement is known as moving inventory. After all machining process have completed on that raw material, then we see that our finished good or our desired product is complete. Then our desired product is kept in the warehouse, and this warehouse is known as finished good inventory, where we keep only finished good products. And after warehouse, the shipment is carried out by transport system, and delivery of finished good to the different market and to the different customers. these are the overall steps from coming out of raw material to the shipment of finished good to end customer of our plant of or any manufacturing unit. This is known as flow of inventory. Why inventory management is necessary for any manufacturing plant or for any production plant? Because of to meet sales expectation, any company described earlier his sales meets or his overall component of sales, then it surely by applying the inventory management, we meet our sales assumptions. To continue unrestricted production, because if any manufacturing plant assist with many machines and many labors, then no one want to be in ideal ideal machine or ideal position of machining or ideal position of mans. Thus, inventory management run the overall production of the company, utilization of the machines and utilization of the manpower to reduce cost, to keep sufficient inventory under and over. Now, these all are the points for considering why inventory management is needed in any manufacturing plant. This is the importance of inventory management in any manufacturing plant, like operating in importance and financial importance. If you're talking about operating importance, then it leads to the availability of material, avoidance of wastage material or avoidance of scraps, promotion of manufacturing efficiency. Promotion of manufacturing efficiency here describe the overall usage of man and machine, avoidance of out of stock danger. Means our finished good is not to be out of stock. Better service to the customer. If you regularly product the, if you regularly production any product and then is reached it re, when it finally comes to the customer, then on the basis of feedback of customer, we can implement variations according to the customer. Then we can say that inventory management is also important for better service to the customer. Here are the some financial importance, like economy of purchasing, reasonable pricing, and effective use of capital. These point consider when we where we can purchase raw material. Like if we purchase appropriate amount of raw material, then the it decrease overall transportation cost, it decrease overall warehouse cost. If any raw material comes at reasonable price, then we may purchase some over raw material for the efficient use of capitals. These all points cover under the importance of inventory management. If questions comes about what are the various importance of inventory management, then we broadly classify into two importance. One is operating and another one is financial importance. In operating importance, the following are the points, like availability of material, avoidance of wastage, promotion of manufacturing efficiency, avoidance of out of stock danger, better service to the customer. In the financial importance, economy of purchasing, reasonable price, and the efficient use of capital. Here are the various stages of inventory management, like decision stage, coordination of purchasing, supplier development, guiding design, decisions, introducing new inventory, and some minor changes in the production process. This overall comes under the decision stage, where management decide to the purchasing of some new material, purchasing of old material. It comes under raw material. and we search about various suppliers, and from those one or two supplier we can fix supply for raw material. Then this is comes under the supplier development, guiding design decisions on the design, on the basis of design decision we can decide the amount of raw material which is needed for ongoing production. Sourcing stage, like make or buy decision, procurement facilities, production planning stage, preparation of master schedule, calculation of inventory requirement, stage of ordering, placing the new order, follow up, packaging and transportation. Stages of ordering consist following points, like we place the order to the various vendors and follow up to the with the various vendors, packaging of that raw material, and we confirm the transportation from the that supplier or from that vendor is ready to come at the point of our manufacturing plant. Now the another stage is receiving stage. At this stage we receive the raw material or we receive the goods from suppliers or from vendor. Inspection, it also consists the inspection of inventory, like quality check of the raw material and the quality problem associated with that type that particular raw material. Inventory control, determination of economic lot size, safety margin and inventory cost. Here the last point describes describe about the benefits, how much quantity we have to order from the any vendor, that this is beneficial for our company, or this is cost cutting process. This is also known as cost cutting process of any company, like economic lot size. This is the overall stages from beginning to end. It is only about raw material inventory. If you're talking about raw material inventory, then this is the stages of raw material inventory, like decision stage where we take decision about raw material, sourcing stage where we can found the sources for supplying this type of raw material, planning stage we prepare master schedule and how much inventory is needed or how much inventory requirement for the production process. Fourth stage is a stage of ordering. We can give order, we can take follow up, packaging and ensure the transportation of the material from the vendors. A receiving stage where we can receive that material, it also include the quality check of that coming raw material, and the inventory control. It suggests that how much inventory is needed for the production of that particular product. Thus we can say that this is the six stages which overall affect the raw material inventory. Now the another part of the inventory management we will discuss in next chapter.